you smile like a summer sky just shining down on me and you. I swear your heart is a free bird on a lazy sunny afternoon.
I love the way that you were up for anything. Never worried about what people say, that's right.
Oh, that's right. What the God is just like driving on an open highway, never knowing what we're gonna find. Just like two kids, baby, always trying to live it up. Whoa, yeah, that's our kind of love.
Hi everyone, so it's been like a week or so since I've made a video for SweetiesTalk, so I wanted to make a video for you guys today. I'm not really sure what I'm going to call this video yet, but I know what I want to talk about. And what I want to talk about is, I guess, for you guys, or really for you ladies, or it could be guys as well, who have been there with your man since the very beginning, since before he even decided to join the military. And I want to talk to you all who, I guess, are going through that phase, or you have a man in boot camp or something like that, whatever the case may be. Just something prior to boot camp and just finding out that, you know, okay, well, my spouse wants to join the military. What do I do now? So that's basically what I want to talk about, if that made any sense. Basically, you know, I'm going to tell you a little bit of my story and how I found out. So when I first met my Marine, I never thought that he wanted to join the military. It wasn't really something we had ever talked about. You know, and that's really when you were to ask me, okay, you know, I thought I was just going to have like your normal husband or whatever who, you know, you'd come home to every day. And obviously that's not the case now because he's in the military, but had you had asked me then, you know, I was only like in 11th grade, so I didn't really think that he was going to join the military. So yeah, like after a few months of dating, then, you know, we talked about it a little bit, and he just tells me before his 18th birthday, practically like a month before, that he wants to join the military. And it's just something he's thought about, but nothing he was absolutely sure that he wanted to do yet, because it's such a life-changing thing. So he finally decided that that's what he wanted to do. He wanted to be a Marine. So when he told me that, I wanted to like burst in tears. I was like, what? No, I don't want you to die. You can't die. If you join the military, you have a high chance of dying. And no, that's what I thought about at first. Sorry, text message. That's what I thought about at first. And it really, really, oh, it's from my baby. Yeah. Anyways, that's what I thought about, and it really, really scared me, the thought of him joining the military, and I was just really nervous, and wasn't sure how to feel, and by that point, I already knew that I was in love with him, so I knew that I wanted to stick with him regardless. One second. So yeah, like I knew that I wanted to be with him regardless of the fact that he wanted to join the military, but I was still in shock. I was scared. I wasn't like, it was very, very new to me, especially because I don't really have anybody in my family that has joined the military or is still active in the military that, you know, I can go to talk to. I didn't really know anybody that was, I didn't have any friends. I didn't know really any spouses that had somebody in the military. So it was just very, very new to me. And I think the fact that it was new to me, I had so many questions. And trust me, you're always going to have so many questions no matter how long it goes on, because if there's one thing you learn that there's always something new happening, always something more that you can learn as far as being a spouse. So that's what I wanted to. I just had so many questions. I wanted to know, okay, when you leave, what's going to happen? What's going to happen? How long are you going to be gone for? When you come back, how is that going to work? And then when you leave, how is that going to work? What if you're stationed all the way across the state? Which he was. He was. And it was, I guess you could say, like, the first time we've actually spent apart. And it was really difficult. Not difficult as in the sense that, you know, it was just hard to continue living my day-to-day life, because that really wasn't. What was difficult for me was the not having him around, not knowing that I will be able to see him every weekend and that I can kiss him and just be like, hey, baby, I miss you. Can I come over? You know, that was what's really hard, that I missed him so much. And it was just, I don't know, it was very, very strange knowing that, okay, my boyfriend wants to join the military, so now I have this amount of time. And lucky for us, he got the privilege to be not sent the day that he was supposed to be sent to boot camp. He got to get sent earlier. So it really caught me by shock. What I thought I had, at least a week or two left, I ended up having a few days. Or really just a week, because they ended up moving in. He was supposed to get shipped out in November. But instead, he got shipped out to boot camp in October. So it was very unexpected. I didn't think that was going to happen at all. You know, you plan for so many months to have so much time with this person. And it was just very, very, very strange. So I guess the sense of this whole thing is that not to try, like, had I watched videos and had I known people, I probably would have felt a little bit comfortable or a little bit more comfortable. But going in, it's really important, or I guess to better help you out, trying to best explain this, as you guys can tell, I'm a little flustered. What I'm trying to say is that I didn't know that the person that I was going to be with wanted to join the military. And I didn't want to leave him because he was joining the military. And today, I couldn't be any more proud than I am this very moment because he's in the military, because of what he does. You know, I'm so proud of him. And had he have just been like an average person and gone to college, I would have equally been just as proud of him. But the fact that he joined the military really makes me proud of him, knowing that he's serving our country and that he's fighting, you know, should he get deployed, he's going to fight for our freedom, fight for our lives, so that we can continue living the kind of lifestyle that we live today. And some people don't realize that, but you know, I really didn't know anything about the military until I knew that he was going to join. I didn't know how things worked. I didn't know what was going to happen. You know, growing up, I was always told a lot of bad things, and about, not necessarily about the military, but as far as relationships, I've always heard a lot of bad things. And that's what really scared me, because I didn't think, you know, okay, if this is what they say, then I am determined to beat those odds. And here we are, still together, and obviously we're beating those odds. I couldn't be any more happier than I am today with him. So I just want to go ahead, and I just want to know, how did you guys feel when you found out that your man wanted to join the military? Were you scared? Were you nervous? I was, like, a whole bunch of things wrapped in one. I was still in school. I was still in high school. I practically did my whole senior year practically all by myself. I didn't really, there's nothing really I regret about my senior year. I did everything the way that I felt I wanted to at that moment. And I think that that's what you guys should do regardless. But how did you guys feel when you found out that your man was going to the military? And if you had any kind of advice for somebody who is now experiencing that and now finding out that their man's going to join the military, what kind of advice would you give them? For me, the advice that I would give somebody, if you're new, I guess, to the whole thing, and you're finding out that your man's going to leave to the military, to, it takes a really strong person, so be very strong. Don't be afraid to cry, because sometimes you can't be strong 24/7, 365 days of the year. Sometimes you're going to go ahead and you're going to break down and you're going to cry. But the way that you handle it is, how do you pick yourself up? You know, are you a strong enough person that you feel that you can handle the distance, that you can handle picking yourself up? Because your man, some of the time, isn't going to be there. He isn't going to be able to pick yourself, you know, pick you up and be like, everything's going to be okay. Even though you know everything's going to be okay, you have to be able to pick yourself up, continue to live day-to-day life. Do a lot of research about your man's branch. Especially, like, I'm getting ready, hopefully, sometime in August to go ahead and move with him. So one of the things that I'm determined to do is learn all the rankings about, you know, everybody in the Marine Corps. I'm trying to learn, start off with there. I want to learn everyone's eventually, but I want to start off with the Marine Corps so that I would be able to address them properly. Had we come across them, like, just walking around the base or just, like, at a PX or a commissary or something like that, and I see one, I'm not like, hey, sir. You know, I can be, like, address them by their actual ranking and their name, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, I hope that was a little bit helpful. I'm really interested in knowing yours all opinion, if that makes sense. Yours all, I'm not sure. So, yeah, I will talk to you guys soon. I'm trying to at least make videos once a week for you guys. I've just really been working a lot, and there's just been a lot of stress going on in my house. A lot of personal things, so I'm really trying to work and save money, but, you know, just, I want to work a lot just so I have a little bit of money to spend and a little money to save as well. So if I can't make a video, I do apologize. I am trying to make them at least once a week, and I hope you guys have a wonderful and fantastic weekend, and I will talk to you guys soon. Bye! Yeah, that's our kind of love.